Hi everyone, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to discuss about digital presentations, that is unit 5. So under unit 5 we are going to see the following topics. First one is inserting a duplicate slide, next one inserting new slides, third one slide layout, and fourth one copying and moving slides, and last one is copying, moving and deleting content. So first one, inserting a duplicate slide. Sometimes we may wish to insert the same slide as the previous one. So that is called a copy of the previous slide, that is otherwise called as duplicate slide. So we can create the same copy what we have created already. Okay, so just like the first page of your book has the title of the book, and the same title it can also appears on the cover page of your book. So in the first page, whatever content or title you are having, the same title will be appearing on the cover page also. That is only called a duplicate. Okay, so similar copy we can create in the slides also. Same slide we can copy and we can paste it in another place. Okay, so how to insert the new, that is duplicate slide we will see. We need to select the slide you want to duplicate from the slide span. So we will have some of the slides. Okay, so left side we have slide pan. Okay, left side of the presentation software we have the slide span. So like this we have slides. So from this, whatever slides we have created, we need to select that slide first. Okay, which slide you want to duplicate? No, you need to select that slide first, and then select from the menu bar slide and duplicate slide. So like this, slide and duplicate slide option we need to choose after selecting the slide what we want to duplicate. Okay, or else we can right click on the slide and select duplicate slide from the menu. So like this, we can right click on the slide what we want to copy and paste it. Okay, so we need to right click on the slide and then we need to duplicate. Click on duplicate slide from the menu. Okay, or we need to right click on the slide in the workspace. Okay, and select the slide option and then duplicate slide from the listed menu. Or else we need to click the duplicate slide icon in the presentation toolbar. So like this, duplicate slide icon will be appearing in the toolbar. So this icon we can click it in order to duplicate the slide. So before that we need to select. Okay, so these are the four options we can use it for duplicating a slide. So we can insert the duplicate slide in the presentation by using one of the above options. So four methods we can use it for duplicating a slide. Next one is inserting. So after inserting a duplicate slide, we can get the presentation like this. Okay, so right click, duplicate slide we can click, and the same slide now will appear once again in the presentation. Okay, next topic is inserting a new slides. To insert a new slide, we need to use the following way. So first one, we need to select from the menu bar slide new slide. So slide new slide option we need to choose from the menu bar. Okay, see, previously we have seen slide new slide. See, click on slide and then new slide option we need to click in order to create the new slide. Okay, so or else we can right click on a slide and select new slide from the context menu. Okay, we need to right click on any slide and we need to choose new slide option. Or else we can right click in an empty space in the workspace and select slide new slide from the context menu. Or we can click new slide icon in the presentation toolbar. Like this, on plus option will be appearing. This is copy. See, already one slide is there. Another slide we can make a duplicate. So that's why it is appearing. That box is it is appearing like a two way. Two boxes are appearing here. Okay, so that means we can make a duplicate slide. So here already one slides are there. So we need to create a new one so that it is coming along with the plus symbol. So it indicates that we can create a new slide. Okay, without any content. Or else we can use the keyboard shortcut menu, that is Control plus M. But for duplicating slides, we don't have shortcut key combination. Okay, if you look at this slide and duplicate slide, there is no shortcut key mentioned here. But if you look at slide and new slide option, there is a shortcut key combination for creating a new slide. So you can see the icon also. So same icon, you can get it from the toolbar. Presentation toolbar is there, standard toolbar. From there we can get this icon. We can click that icon in order to insert the new slide, or else we can click on Control plus M, okay, for creating a new slide. Okay, then so these are the ways, five ways we can use for inserting a new slide. So we can, after inserting, you know, the presentation will be looking like this. Okay, we need to click on this and the new slide will be created. Okay, like this new slide will get created. Next is slide layouts. So layout means what? The outer design, that outlook only is known as layout. So we may have around 15 or 20 slide layouts. That is a structure, different ways we can insert the content, like text, movies, images, charts and tables. Like that we can insert any content. So for that different layouts are available. So for slides, no, different layouts, different designs are available. So after inserting a new slide, we need to choose the layout. Okay, so for example, if you want to compare the two topics, no, so we need to choose two content layout. Okay, title along with two content layout we need to choose. Okay, we will see how many layouts are available in the presentation software. Okay, that is LibreOffice Impress software. Okay, so the layout contains one or more content boxes. Okay, so after inserting a new slide, no, layout will be there. So one default layout will appear. It contains one or more content boxes. So content means what kind of content we can include. Text, movies, images, charts or tables we can insert in the content boxes. We can select the icon based on the content by clicking on the corresponding icon that we want to display as shown in the middle of the content box. See, in the middle of the content box, we have these kind of icons also. So if you click the first icon, it is indicating table. So if you click this first icon, it will insert the table. If you click the second icon, it will insert the chart. If you click the third icon, it will insert the image, okay, pictures. And then fourth icon is for video. So like that we can insert any content in our slide. Okay, to change the slide layout, just select the slide in the slide span. So we have already have some list of slides in the left side of our presentation software. So we need to choose the slide, for which slide we want to change the layout. No, we need to choose that slide, that is selected slide first. Then it will appear in the workspace and then select the desired layout from the layout section in the sidebar. So right side we have the some of the layouts. See, like this we have different layouts. Okay, so we can choose whichever layout we want to insert here. So these boxes only, these rectangular boxes are there. No, these are only indicating this is for comparison. So anything, two topics, if you want to compare, you can go for this layout. Okay, so like that we have so many layouts are there. So according to the content what we want to display, you know, in a presentation, according to that we can choose the layout. So this is called a sidebar. Okay, right side is known as sidebar. So from this we can choose the any layout for the selected slide. So which slide you are selecting, that slide will be applied with that layout what you are choosing. Okay, so this is slide pan. So left side, whatever space we have, no, left side. Okay, this is known as slide span. So whatever slides we are creating, that slides will be appearing with the with its number. Okay, so only one slide till now we have created here in this example. So it is just showing only one slide. So like that, if you are creating a number of slides, the slides will be appearing here. Okay, so several layouts contain one or more content boxes. If you look at here, content boxes are available as one or more. Okay, to use the content box for the text, we need to click to add text and enter the text as you want to display in the slide. So we need to click any content, no, as a text. If you want to display, you need to click to add text, no, inside this you should click it. After getting the cursor, you can start typing any content or any text. The slides once created can be reused within the presentation or in another presentation. So for that only we can go for copying and moving slides. Okay, so we can use the same slide in the same presentation also, or else we can move that slide to another presentation also. So it is possible. So what are the techniques we can use it for copy and moving slides, that we will see now. So to move the slide to the another location, we need to use cut and paste. Move means what? Permanently, that in a old location, that slide will be removed. Okay, from the old location, it will be removed permanently and it will be placed on the new location. That is only known as moving. So in the old location, that slide will not be available. Okay, to copy the slide, so we need to use the process copy and paste. To move, cut and paste. So cut means from that old location, it will be removed. Okay, copy and paste means old location also one copy will be available, one slide will be available, same slide will be pasted in the another location. So two way we can copy and move the slides. First one we will see cut and paste. To cut and paste something in the presentation, we need to select the slide. So because we are focusing on slides now, so we need to select the slide, which slide we want to cut and paste it by marking it in the slide sorter view. Either we can choose slide sorter view or on the left side of the screen in the normal view. See, we can go for view, slide sorter view. So if you created around 20 slides, that's 20 slides will be appearing like a small boxes. So in that, which slide you want to copy and paste it, no, you can choose easily if you go for slide sorter view. So like this, four boxes are appearing on the same way. How many slides are there? All those slides will be appearing on the same single page itself, single window itself. So in the slide sorter view, you can choose the slide, or else in the normal view from the left side span, no, by using scroll bar, we can scroll and choose the slide. We can select the slide first, and then only we need to apply copy and paste and cut and paste option. Okay. So click on the rightmost button. After selecting the slide, we need to click on the rightmost button and select the cut option if you want to move it. Okay. If you want to copy it, we need to choose the copy option from the context menu. See, you can see, look at here, select the slide and then right click on that slide. You need to choose copy option, or else Ctrl plus C shortcut key also you can use it for copying. Okay. If you want to paste it in another location, you want to have the same copy in the old location also, means you need to go for copy option, or else you can go for cut option. Cut option will be permanently removing from the old location. So slide will not be available in the old location. Okay. So cut and paste for moving, copy and paste for copying. So next one, you need to mark the place in the presentation where you want to move or copy the slide. So in the presentation where you want to copy or move, no, you need to choose that location first. And then right click the mouse button, select the paste option from the context menu. So like this, we need to select the paste option from the context menu. Keyboard shortcuts, what and all we can use it here, means for cut option, we can go for Ctrl plus X. For copy, Ctrl plus C. For paste, Ctrl plus V. Okay. So these combination of keys, we can use it for copy and paste, cut and paste and all. So next one is drag and drop copying and moving method. So for drag and drop method, we need to select the slide that we want to copy. And then we need to click and hold the leftmost button. So leftmost button, we need to click and hold it on the marked slide. Which slide we want to copy, you know, we need to click on that slide and hold down the leftmost button. Don't release the leftmost button. You need to press the leftmost button. And also at the same time, you need to press the or hold down the control key also in the keyboard. So control key and leftmost button both should be pressed when you want to drag the slide to another location. So after dragging, okay, so move the mouse cursor to the desired location. You need to move the mouse cursor now in order to drag it. And then release the leftmost button and then release the control button. So first one, you have pressed the leftmost button. Next only you have pressed the control button. Now for releasing also, leftmost button need to be released first, and then only you need to release the control button. So the copy is pasted to the another location where you have placed the mouse cursor. Okay. So moving the text via drag and drop method can be done in the same way like copying, but without using the control button. Okay. Without control button, text can be moved easily. Slide, if you want to move, you need to use the control button also. So now cut key is used for, cut option is used for moving the slide, and copy option is used for copying the slide, and paste, no, we can use it paste option for pasting it in a new location. So next one is deleting a slides. To delete any slide from a presentation, first we need to select the slide, okay, in the slide pan. Then right click the mouse button on the selected slide. You will get the option like this, delete slide option. You can select that slide, delete slide option. Another way is to delete the slide. That is quick way to delete the slide is just select the slide and press the delete button from the keyboard. These are the two ways we can delete. One is right click on the slide what you want to delete and choose delete slide option. Another way is just press delete button from the keyboard after selecting the slide which you want to delete. Next one is renaming a slide. So changing the name, changing the slide name into a new slide. Okay. So the slides are named as slide 1, 2, 3 by default. By default, how the slides are named? 1, 2, 3 like that. Okay. It is possible to give the name to the slide by renaming it. So for that we need to select the slide by marking them in the slide pan, and then right click the mouse button on the selected slide and choose rename slide option, and then rename slide dialog box will appear where you can assign a new name. See, like this you need to choose the slide, and then rename slide option you need to choose, and then rename slide dialog box will appear. Inside that you give the new name for that and click on OK. So title slide we have given. Slide 2 name is changed as title slide, and you need to click OK. So that name will be changed to slide 2. Okay, next is copying, moving and deleting content. This is the last topic in your today's lesson. Impress is the component of LibreOffice. So it is one of the component. Impress is also one of the component. Already we discussed about LibreOffice Calc. Same way, LibreOffice Impress is also one of the component. So we can use the same commands and options that of the LibreOffice Writer, no, for text editing. In LibreOffice Impress also we can use the same commands for editing, text editing. That means what? Copying text and moving a text, deleting the text. So for slides, whatever options we have used, same options we can apply for a text also. Okay, so to copy or move some object or text, object means any picture also. Okay, so text or an object in the presentation to another location in the same presentation or another presentation, it is necessary to first select the text. So whatever you want to move it to another location or in the same location, we need to select the content first, okay, or select the slide first. So if you want to move the slide, select the slide. If you want to move the text or object to another location or in the same presentation software or some other place, you need to select the text first, okay. So select the text and click the right mouse button. So copy option will be chosen from the menu, okay, context menu. Okay, or else we can click on Control plus C. Okay, Control key and C you need to be pressed simultaneously in the keyboard. Okay, for copying for cut option we need to choose Control plus X to cut. Position the cursor on the location on the slide to which you want to move or copy the content. We need to choose the location and we need to place the cursor first inside the slide. And then press the right mouse button and select paste option from the context menu, or we can press Control plus V. Next one is deleting the text. It is easy to delete the text of the slide. We need to choose the text first. Okay, we need to select the text first, and we can press the delete option or backspace button on the keyboard to delete the text. So what delete key will do and backspace key will do? So delete key, it will delete the characters on the right side of the cursor. You need to understand clearly, both backspace key and delete keys are used for deleting the text. So if you press the delete key, cursor's right side, whatever, so you will see cursor. Okay, if you get the cursor like this, cursor's right side, whatever letters are appearing, no, that will be deleted if you press the delete key. If you press the backspace key, by the name itself we can understand, back side it will delete. That means left side of the cursor it will delete character by character. Okay, so pressing delete key or backspace keys delete one character at a time. It will not delete entire text or entire word. If you select the text or word or line entirely only, if you press the delete key or backspace key, it will fully erase the text. Okay, but if you without selecting, if you press just delete key and backspace key, it will delete the character one by one. If you press delete, right side it will start deleting. If you press backspace, left side of the cursor, it will start deleting one by one, character by character. So alternatively we can use the cut option also to delete the text. So to delete that line or a paragraph of text, we need to select the text and then you need to press the delete key. Okay, next is undoing and returning the changes. Okay, so undo redo options we will see now. So any mistakes if we are making, no, we can go for undo option. So without knowing something happened in a wrong way, so we can press undo option from the standard toolbar that I will show now. Or else Control plus Z we can do, which is that we can click in the keyboard in order to do undo, or edit undo also we can go. So when we execute a command on some text, for example delete the text, we are able to reverse what we have done. Okay, so this is known as the undo function. It is also possible after having undone the change, we can get it back. That is called a redo. Okay, after undo, again we want to go back to the last action, that is the next action, we can use the redo function. For that Control Y is used, Control Z for undo. Okay, so these undo and redo icons are available in the standard toolbar. Sometimes we may apply any command or any option by mistake. So to revert this mistake, there is a function called undo. It returns the document to the previous state. So pressing the key combination Ctrl plus Z undoes the last change you have made. So pressing it again will undoes the one before that. So before that, what you have done, that also will be undone if you click again. If you press the Ctrl Z again, or if you click undo again. Alternatively, we can go for edit and undo. Edit menu we can click, and in that we can choose undo option. So using this method, the menu will indicate what type of operations you will be undoing. So another way to do this is to press the undo icon on the function bar. See, like this undo icon is there in the toolbar, and redo, this is redo. Okay, so left side arrow means that is undo, right side if arrow mark is marking pointing means that is redo option. It is going back to last state, that is to next state. Okay, redo means next state. So from undo it will go to again redo, next state. So redo function is used to revert the result of undo. Okay, reverse the result of undo function, that is only redo function. Okay, it can be used many times as the undo function was used. To use this function, we can go for edit and redo, or else we can press Ctrl plus Y. Okay, thank you. With this, we will end up the today's session. In the afternoon session, you will get questions related to this video.